Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will look at best practices for presenting tables and figures in your research paper. If you still haven't subscribed to this channel, please click the subscribe button below. One of the important components of the results section is figures and tables. Try to present your data in figures and tables wherever necessary. One of the common questions asked by students is when should they present the data in figures and tables instead of putting it directly in the text? The best way to answer the question is if you cannot present your data in your text in one or two lines, then you should consider putting it in a figure or a table. Another common question that comes up is how to choose between a figure and a table for presenting the data. The best way to answer this question is if you want to illustrate the trends and patterns in the data, then a figure is the best option. If you want to show the actual values or present a lot of numerical information in your paper, then a table might be the best way to go. Here is an example. Look at the way the authors have used tables and figures to describe their results. In the first couple of lines, they are talking about a trend in their data that relates to the change in temperature over time. They are constantly referring to the figure to get their point across to the readers. And finally, in the last sentence, they are telling the readers that the actual numerical data is provided in the table, and they can refer to it if they want. This is a standard way to use figures and tables in your research paper. When you are using figures and tables in your paper, you must reference them in your text. You cannot have a figure in your paper and not talk about it in your text. Another important thing is that your figure should have a caption that clearly explains what it is about. Most people skim through the paper just going through figures and tables without reading any text in the paper. So captions should be as short as possible, but detailed enough for the readers to understand the figure or table without having to read the text. Another common mistake made by both beginner writers and experienced writers is repeating the figure caption in the text when referring to the figure in the paper. Look at this example. The author repeats exactly what it says in the figure caption in the text. The author is saying that the figure shows the change in temperature over time. This is already mentioned in the figure caption. There is nothing new here. Now, look at the second example. While referring to the figure, the author provides some additional information to the readers by talking about an interesting trend in the figure instead of just repeating the figure caption. So, try to make your results section crisp and concise by reducing unnecessary information and words. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you still haven't installed Ref and Write software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, proofreading tools, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. If you are interested in training courses on research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy on Udemy. You can find the link in the description below. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now!